Our walk takes us along the boulevard Unter den Linden that looks back over a long and rich tradition. The first step towards transforming the street into a boulevard was taken by the prince-elector Friedrich Wilhelm. From 1647 on, he gave orders to plant lime and walnut trees along the avenue, and by and by, residential buildings were erected, generally meant for the nobility, high-ranking military personnel, court staff, and other persons of rank. After the foundation of the Imperial Reich in 1871, the avenue changed its appearance and became a commercial street. Famous cafés, glittering temples of consumerism, branches of countless companies and banks made sure that business kept swinging. If you go further down the road, you will notice that the war tore big gaps here too. The exhausting clearance was done mostly by the Berlin Trümmerfrauen, as the women were called, clearing away the debris. On the picture, you can see a woman working as an engine driver, steering a small, improvised debris train through the freshly planted lime trees in 1947. In the 1960s, East Germany was keen to present itself as a modern, industrialised country, which led to the construction of many new edifices along the avenue. As a result, the contrasts between historic and modern structures are often strong. After German reunification, the boulevard changed its character again due to extensive construction work. Today, it is mainly used by companies for entrepreneurial presentation, for example, vehicle manufacturers showing not only their latest models, but also lines of business such as media companies have located themselves here. On the opposite side, to the right, you can see the historical business building Zollernhof. Here, the second German television channel, ZDF, established by the German federal states, has opened its studio of the capital. In so doing, the important public service broadcaster has chosen the building of the former seat of the East German state youth organisation, FDJ. The photo shows you that the FDJ often used the facade for propaganda campaigns against the imperialist class enemy in the time of the Cold War. Here the banner says, "Hands off Korea, Americans go home." Do you like this video clip? Please subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.